Hello and welcome to TSM. I'm Steve. Today we're just going to do a shortest video of how I have done my Katinga battle cruiser from the Klingon from the Star Trek original motion picture. We're going to go over to the bench, have a look at it, what I've done, show you bits and pictures, and hopefully we'll get some build pictures in there as well, some of the progress pictures, and if I can squeeze it in a little short little video in between of what I've done, of how I've tried to do similar to what there was on the screen. I don't know if it's going to pan out or not, but we'll see. So we'll head over to the bench. Right, so here we are. We have the Klingon Katinga 1350. It's a big ship. It's probably in total just about just short of 2 foot long. It's a very nice kit. It's a lovely looking kit as well, I think. It's very much representative of the film. There's going to be a bit of, I think it represents the movie model very, very well, I think. So how do we do this? All the masking, which is on top and all over the ship, is all being done by hand. I haven't used any of the masking sheets that you can get from Lou, Aztec Dummy. I've done it all by hand, just using the Tamiya tape and knife. So basically just cutting, stripping out, and then using the knife to cut out. I sprayed the very light green coat very first, then went on to the next bit darker shade, and then on to the very dark one. I think the final one I used for the dark, final dark, was a Tamiya LP paint. This is the first time I've used these. Not too bad. I'm quite pleased. They do spray very well. I will say that. This was LP 56. I just did find that it's cleaning of the airbrush can take, you can't really use a normal airbrush cleaner. I used cellulose thinners just to clean up the airbrush, which, okay, it's not that hard, much of a problem, but it's just not as quick and easy as when you use a Tamiya XFs and Xs. This lamp keeps going out. I don't know why it wants to keep doing that, but we'll see. Very masking, etc. Decals went down very well. I used the microsole, etc. If we can get the underside, there we go. Yeah, so we've got some electricity in the back there. But yeah, so again, all the masking, etc. The decal on the back went down very well. That's a very nice decal. That decal is actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 parts, that decal. But yeah, went on all right. I'm pleased with it. The one problem I did have was securing the neck to the main body. I tried all sorts. I tried an epoxy resin glue, 12 minute epoxy, super glue. In the end, I think it was a combination of everything in the end. But we got there in the end. And as I said, you could see just now, we have got some electricity in the bottom. So let's just plug that in. So what I should do really is turn these two off, and we can see a bit better of the lighting. So let's start at the front here. So you can see we've got the So we've got the lighting on the front of the X-ray. We've got the red of the bridge, and that was wasn't hard to do, but the kit does come with a resin top. I found it, although it was detailed very well, the fit onto the rest of the model wasn't that great, and it was going to take a lot of fettling and everything, and I just like, nah, so didn't do. I did buy a phase board for the torpedo, but for some reason I just couldn't get it to work and I went through two. So what I've done is I've just put it on a switch, so it just comes on and off again. On and off again. So it sort of does sort of fade in a little bit, but not very well. The lighting around this should be more prominent. I have got LED strip in the bottom of there, but it hasn't really, I think it's fallen. I didn't secure it properly because you can only see in certain areas where the light actually comes through. So it's not that great, but it's okay. We've got LEDs in the back, shining back, and then we have the flashing. This is just a flash LED bulb. It's not a circuit or anything like that. It just flashes at a constant rate. And then we have the engine area intake there. Now what I did there was I put in, let me just turn that on off as well. I actually put in red flicker lights and orange flicker lights, so you get sort of like that flickering sort of effect. We've got LED strip behind here and here to show the light in here. And I just noted a piece of pieces come off there, so I need to rectify that. Then on the side we've got just a 3mm LED, and again there just shining down. And then at the back, I decided to just have this on full, not on, that should be a face cannon, but I just did it as it was with just a constant light. But again, I've used flicker red LEDs to give it like engine like effect, and then two small 3mm LEDs in the back. And then I did use the clear plastic inside to light the two bits on these engines or nacelles, whatever you call them. And it's okay, it's not that bright, but it's okay. So overall I am pretty pleased. Oh, and there's we can do it. We got the LEDs in the bottom there as well. Putting it on that camera. And I've just broken another bit. You have to be very careful with this model. I'm gonna have to stop playing around with this. So I've just broken another bit, sorry, whoops. LEDs shining down there and on the back, and just one on the bottom there. So yeah, overall I'm pretty pleased. I just need to stop handling it to knocking these parts. I need to put them back on and get them fixed in place. So, and then just not touch the model at all, because that is quite annoying. That's not going to come on. Let's get that one on. That light is very temperamental today. So yeah, so overall I'm pretty pleased with it, and it just doesn't last now. Yeah, pretty pleased with it. I need to glue that back on there. That's a bit annoying. Hope you like what you see. I'm pleased with it. It's a very nice kit. One thing I would say, I've done my own lighting with this. You can buy the lighting kit to go with it, which in the UK it's just short of £100, but it's £99 like it. That does come with a little bit of PE as well, but it is just literally on the front of the, you know, the spoon. But I just don't think it's worth it. £100 for some LEDs. Okay, it's all pre-wired and everything. You haven't got to do any soldering, etc. like that. If you're not used to doing soldering and you can't solder, then fine, fair enough. It's you should perhaps get it if you really want to light it up. But the soldering isn't that bad. You can do it easily enough if you've had to do some practice. You just need to remember to get your resistors in, or you can buy pre-resisted LEDs, which I have got in some of these places in these, especially in like these ones here and here. The ones on the back, the flicker ones, aren't, I have to put a resistor on them, but it's not too bad. It's quite easy enough once you get used to doing it. Gets off, doesn't have to be all singing, all dancing soldering iron, but a good one is a fairly decent one. You can pick them up relatively inexpensively. Would you make sure you use the flux on the joint? And I would also recommend, well, I can get it. I just got this box off of Amazon or eBay. They're just sleeves, and you just put these over the joint. They come in various widths, so obviously the bigger the joint, the bigger the piece of it. And all you do there, you just get your soldering iron once that's on over the thing, and just use the edge just to melt it or shrink it around the wire. So I got that just for this, just to keep it all neat and tidy, so you don't have any bare wire showing. And yeah, once you've done that and you get used to doing it, it's you get used to doing it and you can really expand what you want to do. Now there are a lot of other programs you can do. There's Arduino board and stuff like that, which can do various different things, which I'm not into yet. I do need to try and have a look at learning that, but hey, that will come eventually. So yeah, we'll head back round and see what's, and we'll do a close. Right, so there you have it. That's the Katinga. Fully enjoyed this build. It was a gift from the birthday club, or the ISM birthday club, a year ago. And I'm very pleased with it. I love it. It goes with my 1350 Polar Lights Enterprise, and I also have a Polar Lights 1350 Bird of Prey, which I'm going to do at some point, maybe not this year, but at some point, so that all three of them will sit together on my shelf. So yeah, thanks for watching. Please give the video a like, please subscribe, and we've got the Facebook group Totally Scam Models as well, and we also have our Saturday Night Live crash. On a Saturday night, we live stream from 8 p.m. UK time. Not sure what time that is over in the States and what have you, but that's normally hosted between me, TSM, Carl Smith for Making Models, or James Skiffins, which is the model officer. So look for their YouTube channels, look for the posts. We do post it in various groups, the link etc. to come along, but yeah, look for us on Facebook and on YouTube, and we'll see you there. So take care, thanks for watching, bye bye.
Your money can affect how you feel now more than ever.
Setting a savings goal to fund your dreams feels amazing.
And a financial plan for your future feels smart.
Knowing your monthly repayments are as low as can be helps you sleep at night.
That's why we're offering every customer a free video financial health check.
Because when your money is in a better place, so are you.
Every one of us is here to support you.
Of doing your tax on the walls, I see.
QuickBooks automatically checks your tax return for errors.